محافظين على التقاليد الراسخة التي اكتسبها القضاء المصري على مر العصور، ليؤكد حرص الرئيس على ترسيخ دولة القانون وما تتضمنه من إنفاذ على الجميع واحترام استقلال القضاء وصون كرامته.
Excellencies, honorable guests, welcome to the celebrations marking the golden anniversary of the Supreme Constitutional Court of Egypt under the auspices of His Excellency Abdel Fattah el-Sisi, President of the Arab Republic of Egypt. The Supreme Constitutional Court of Egypt is the highest judicial power in the country and is responsible for interpreting the legislative texts and also judging the constitutionality of the laws and the regulations. Congratulations on the occasion. The anniversary is always an occasion to acknowledge with gratitude the support received and also an opportunity to thank all those of you who came to celebrate and to recognize the achievements of Egypt's Supreme Constitutional Court. Golden Jubilee celebrations will not only be an occasion to be nostalgic about the past, but to look forward to the future with confidence and hope as we look back on with pride. Well, we all send our warmest good wishes to you all on the occasion.
خير ما نستهل به حفلنا آيات بينات من الذكر الحكيم يتلوها علينا القارئ الشيخ ياسر الشرقاوي.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات سندخلهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا لهم فيها أزواج مطهرة ندخلهم ظلا ظليلا إن الله يأمركم أن تؤدوا الأمانات إلى وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ أَنْ تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ فَإِنْ تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ فردوه إلى الله والرسول إن كنتم تؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر ذلك خير وأحسن تأويلا صدق الله العظيم.
السادة الحضور، ضيوف مصر الكرام، إن الاحتفال باليوبيل الذهبي للقضاء الدستوري في مصر هو ليس احتفال فقط بمرور 50 عاما على القضاء الدستوري وإنشاء المحكمة الدستورية العليا، بل هو احتفال بترسيخ وثبات دولة القانون، والتي تستهدف تنمية الوعي الدستوري ودوره في حماية حقوق وحريات المواطنين، والتواصل في منظومة التعاون القضائي الدولي، وتبادل الخبرات مع الدول والثقافات المختلفة للاستفادة من قوة المحكمة الدستورية العليا التي تم نقل تجربتها وخبراتها في العديد من الدول.
Well, Excellencies, a very important celebration, a great exposure for Egypt to the whole world, and also to make use of this exposure and transfer the sense of expertise and also the strength of the Supreme Constitutional Court of Egypt and the different experiences disseminating this important message throughout the world.
كلمة السيد المستشار الدكتور عادل عمر شريف نائب رئيس المحكمة الدستورية العليا والأمين العام للاحتفالية.
We'll start the keynote speeches by a speech on Chief Justice, the Supreme Constitutional Court of Egypt, the Secretary General of the celebrations.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السيد المستشار سعيد مرعي رئيس المحكمة الدستورية.
Mr. Saeed Marai, the President of the Constitutional Supreme Court, Mr. Councillor Muhammad Hassan Abdulrahim, the Minister of Justice, His Honorable Dr. Muhammad Guma, the Ministry of Waqfs, the good esteemed guests of Egypt, chiefs of constitutional and the Supreme Court and constitutional councils, chief judges from our brotherly countries, Mr. Ministers, leaders of the armed, commanders of the armed forces, and esteemed guests, and the adopted ambassadors of the Republic of Egypt. My colleagues, the President of the Constitutional Court, ladies and gentlemen, good esteemed guests. Today is a great day that we live in a very historical moment that the Supreme Constitutional Court is celebrating the 50th anniversary Golden Jubilee on the establishment of the constitutional jurisdiction in Egypt, honoring the such a pioneer court, and my informants of the supervision of such a celebration to the collaboration of my colleagues, the members of the court and its delegates, commissioners, I would like to welcome the esteemed guests, the presidents and councillors of the Constitutional Court, the Supreme Court, and the Constitutional Councils, who dedicated their ritual time and burden to the travels to participate our joy of such celebrations in continuation to the consultations of the common interest. We'd like to welcome you all in Egypt, the land of the human civilization, the land of justice, tolerance, and peace, the land of peace and security, a country that the Almighty God said in his holy book, Enter Egypt, God willing, in peace. Welcome you. Thank you for honoring us of your presence in just a great event. Ladies and gentlemen, 5 decades of the links of the establishment of just a giant, the Egyptian constitutional law, embodied in the Supreme Constitutional Court, the top court in the Egyptian jurisdiction. 5 decades have witnessed challenges and achievements. Such a court through which participated in drawing and laying down the protections of the and the liberties of individuals and the guardian of the state as the control of peace and security in the society, putting in their heart the human, no matter their nationalities, the citizens, no matter their religions, are embodying in all judges the rules of just, right, and equality without any provoked discrimination. And also triggering the constitutional awareness for the legislators and the rulers by following the court of a very sound methodology that established in a very precise balance by of the considerations of liberty and the role that we are proud of. Today, if the walls have articulated that clearly talked about the great role by the pillars of this court, the constitutional judges, the guardians of justice, that vested us of a great effort of and a great extent of their knowledge and their distinctive participation and contribution to of the just concept. In order to achieve the effective, the constitutional just on the levels of the civilized countries. This came without any attachment to the Egyptian identity or the principles that formed the such identity. So a great solution for our grand chiefs that paved the ways and became the light of our path to continue. Ladies and gentlemen, throughout the past 50 years, the Supreme Constitutional Court never been away of the changes of jurisdictions on the both levels, internationally and domestically. On the contrary, it has a great role of its modernizations that is not limited domestically, but it has very prominent contributions on the Arabic and African levels, reaching the international one. Today that we are proud of, that our court has become the premises of the Arab Constitutional Court and a very effective member, and became, in addition, thanks to Mr. Councillor Abdul Wahab Abdul Razik, and an umbrella of a high level of the chiefs and the councillors of the Constitutional Supreme and Supreme Court in our motherly continent in Africa, and aimed a place of bilateral agreements on the constitutional entities internationally, that it was aimed the exchange of expertise and knowledges in order to enrich the principles of the constitutional jurisdictions and its results of embodying the rights and protecting the rights in the international community. Such a word that all the pillars and spaces being paved to produce and introduce the common collaboration. Such our gathering is an affirmation of such an orientation that the Supreme Constitutional Court chosen as always, and through the high-level dialogue that includes all the tops of the constitutional schools throughout the world. And there's no doubt that just around the table of such a galaxy would have a great importance of what has been laid down of very fruitful and enriched discussions in protecting the human rights in the law state and the methodology of the jurisdiction in confronting corruption and the cooperation of the Supreme and Constitutional Courts, taking into consideration the impact of technological impact. It is only a clear and crystal goal to develop the legal conception and searching the proper solutions in facing the common challenges in each country of all world. It is the role of the Egyptian Supreme Constitutional Court through the international cooperation system that is based that its methodology was based upon, promising to continue such a path in the following steps, God willing. Ladies and gentlemen, to conclude, I found it is imperative to mention thankfully to those who sponsored and organized such a gathering to come up of a form that is proper for our presence of the State of Egypt. All the thanks for His Excellency Mr. President Abdel Fattah El Sisi to take such an event under His Excellency, His auspices. It is also imperative to thank the Republic of Arab of Egypt of the fruitful cooperation and support that led such a historical celebration, in top of which Mr. Premier, His Excellency, Mr. Premier, Ministries of Defense, Finance, and Investment, and the international ceremonies and conferences. I'd like also to thank my colleagues, the members of the Supreme Constitutional Court, for their sincere exerted efforts to prepare such an event. Hence, I would like to point out that His ex-counselor, Dr. Al Ghifali, the previous chief of the court, has the privilege and the credit of preparing such an event to be followed by the current chief of the court, His Excellency Mr. Councillor Murray, to lift it up to such a high level.
استشعارا منه لأهمية هذا الحدث لمحكمتنا وبلادنا وللمجتمع القضائي الدولي على حد سواء. جزاهم الله خيرا على كل ما بذلاه من جهد محمود في هذا المقام. وختاما شكرا للحضور الكرام وكل الشكر لضيوفنا الأعزاء، ومرة أخرى مرحبا بكم في مصر المحروسة بإذن الله، ولتحيا مصر دوما محبة للسلام، ولتحيا مصر دائما وابدا عنصرا فاعلا في التواصل والتعاون الدولي في جميع المجالات الحضاريه والانسانيه وقبله للعدل والامن والسلام. والسلام عليكم ورحمه الله.
القضاء اشرف تكليف انساني، وهو الدعامة والأساس والأهم في أي مجتمع مدني. وقد أولى الإسلام القضاء قدسية عظيمة وأنزله منزلة لا تدانيها منزلة، إقراراً وتأكيداً لدوره الجليل والأساسي. فالقضاء عند الأمم رمز لسيادتها واستقلالها وعنوان تآلفها ووحدتها، والأمة التي لا قضاء فيها لا حق ولا عدل فيها أشبه ما تكون بمجتمع الغابة أو أضل. فرسوخ القضاء في أمة من الأمم دليل على ثباتها واستقرارها وتطور العقل فيها ودرجة مستوى التفكير الذي وصلت إليها.
Ladies and gentlemen, we continue the keynote speeches for the opener, and now a speech on behalf of His Virtue, Muhammad Mukhtar Guma, Minister of Endowments and Religious Affairs.
كلمة الأستاذ الدكتور محمد مختار جمعة وزير الأوقاف.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد خاتم أنبيائه ورسله وعلى رسل الله أجمعين. سيادة المستشار سعيد مرعي رئيس المحكمة الدستورية العليا، معالي المستشار محمد حسام عبد الرحيم وزير العدل، سيادة المستشار عادل عمر الشريف نائب رئيس المحكمة الدستورية أمين عام الاحتفالية، السادة الوزراء، السادة رؤساء المحاكم الدستورية والهيئات القضائية، السادة نواب رئيس المحكمة الدستورية العليا وأعضاء والأفاضل، السادة ممثلو قواتنا المسلحة الباسلة، الحضور الكريم. بداية يطيب لي أن أهنئ المحكمة الدستورية العليا رئيسا ونوابا وأعضاء باليوبيل الذهبي للمحكمة، متمنيا كل التوفيق للمحكمة في مسيراتها الدستورية.
Rather, it is a case and the path of the wealth. And it is enough to be said that is a state out of order. There is no basis of a state that lack the law and a governing constitution, as well as there is no peace for any state that lack a comprehensive justice. That is also there is no peace for the world order without a real and comprehensive and choosing justice, so there will be no peace for the whole world without a comprehensive and unchosen justice. That way is only one way and not several ones. If the scholars of the politics affirming that the state is based on three pillars, which are the land, people and the governing authority, and following such the modern world order that added the legal dimension to reform a state under the international acknowledgement of the international law, as well as there is no state to build its system away of and agreements, international systems, rather constitutional laws. But the extremist groups built their ideologies on the attempt, or rather bid to establish a conflict between or a difference between the religion and jurisdiction, and whether they be in their perspective with the religion or rather to be what they called the human laws in very long and wrong concepts. Rather, I would like to say that the sound comprehension of the governing cannot be a way of laying out the laws for the interests of the people that achieve the public and the high interest of the communities. And rather, the considerable interest is in the considerations of the religion. Religion and the law are equal, that building the equivalent principles of the citizens without any discriminations of the color or race.
And the religion.
In particular, the responsibilities and rights to work all together for the interests of the whole people. Law and religion pushing for the production and work and expelling the unemployment and lousy and destruction and the treasury and disable the conceptions with our confirmation the importance of restrictions in the constitution of each country
and
not to have a parallel authority for the authorities of the state no matter where are they coming from they are all under one umbrella and the light of the other systems but each entity, group, or a party is to have a flag that is in parallel of the state that poses a threat, not goes in parallel of the flag of the state that is governed by the law and the constitution. To conclude, some verses of a poem written by the poet Hafiz Ibrahim in the light of the rule of Umar ibn al-Khattab, showing that the justice was the path of the security. By saying the sound word became an example. The generation following others saying this word when you are a believer, when you establish the just among the people, when you slept peacefully, giving us the fears of the Almighty God.
دعاك به وكم أخفت قويا ينثني تيها فلا الضعيف ضعيفا بعد حجته فلا الضعيف ضعيفا بعد حجته وإن تخاصم واليها واعيها ولا القوي قويا أخ معزته عند الخصومة
والفوضى فمن يبايع أبا حفص وسيادة
أو من يحاول للفاروق تشبيها
We wish to cooperate all together in establishing the comprehensive justice domestically and internationally, and peace be upon you all. Jurisdiction is an independent authority of the civilized nations, practicing their rules, adding to their roles of improving their role among the nations. The Constitutional Court's role extended beyond our borders through its role in the Arab and African arenas.
Excellencies, we're still honored by your gracious presence today, and now the speech goes to His Excellency Mohammed Hossein Abdelrahim, Minister of Justice.
كلمة السيد المستشار محمد حسام عبد الرحيم وزير العدل.
In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most passionate, Mr. Counselor Saeed Marri, the President of the Supreme Constitutional Court, esteemed counselors, deputies of the court's heads, members of the Supreme Constitutional Commission, good esteemed guests, presidents of courts and constitutional councils, and its delegations. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of His Excellency Mr. President Abdel Fattah Sisi, the President of the Republic, the auspices of such a gathering, and in representative of His Minister Premier, Dr. Mustafa Madbouly, on behalf of whom I'd like to congratulate the court in the occasion of the 50th anniversary of the establishment of the Constitutional Court. If events and incidents were difficult to count, so the role of such role was very important event in throughout the history to write in Latin words. As a symbol of the independence of the Egyptian jurisdictions and its balance of the both authorities, legislative and executive, by affirming the necessity of the litigations, of the supervisions of the judges, of several roles, and its commitments of any branch or delegated if they were overcome and overpassed such rules. With such a very orientation, His Excellency Mr. President of the Republic has issued the Decree 81 of 1963 to establish the Supreme Constitutional Court to having the role of supervision of litigation since 1970 till the 9th of October of 1970, such a date that the Supreme Constitutional Court has replaced the Supreme Court. Based on the law, Decree number 48 of 1970, that articulated that the Supreme Constitutional Court as a supreme independent authority to have the role of interpreting the legislations. In 2030, by the ambition of achieving liberty and social justice, the Constitution expressed such a desire that raise the role of the Supreme Constitutional Court to be their roles abided by its independent deputies, that they are not capable to be dissolved according to the article of 1949 of the Constitution 2013. Among such judges, by talking such very elegant legislation, clear and crystal of the principle to adjust the rights acknowledged by the civilized nations and given the required rights, given into consideration the social and economic and political rights of the community to preserve the societal mindset between the citizen and the state. You've avoided by the rules and we're keen to maintain it very absolutely. You have by me and the Egyptians and agreed solutions of the anniversary of the Supreme Constitutional Court in its 50th anniversary. And thank you and peace be upon you all. The Supreme Constitutional Court, celebrating the 50th anniversary of the establishment of the Constitutional Court, have succeeded in enriching the constitutional jurisdiction in the mindset of the Egyptian citizens, whether through the website of the court or the media. The Supreme Court have chosen to be the elegant and the highest level in the minds of the Egyptians, confronting whoever is going to have any aggressions of such rights that overcome the regional level by the supervision of the jurisdictions of the jurisdiction form of such issued jurisdiction.
Celebrating the Golden Jubilee of the Supreme Constitutional Court of Egypt, the court has succeeded throughout history in enriching Egypt's judicial life and has a great status in the history of Egypt and also in the heart of all Egyptians. Now the speech goes to Honorable Said Merai, the Chief Justice of the Supreme Constitutional Court of Egypt. Excellency.
كلمة السيد المستشار سعيد مرعي عمرو رئيس المحكمة الدستورية العليا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The name of Allah, the most merciful, the most passionate. His Excellency Mr. Councillor Muhammad Hassan Abdul Rahim, the Minister of Justice, Excellencies, Chiefs of Jurisdictional Entities and Authorities, good esteemed guests, Chiefs of Courts, Constitutional Councils and Supreme Courts,
مرحبا بكم في دار العدالة
الدستورية at the House of the Constitutional Court, the House of Justice, such a great jurisdiction house at the immortal Nile River. As a guardian of its constitution chosen by its people, To start, I'd like to give very thanks, very much thanks to His Excellency, Mr. President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi, the President of the Republic, for his acceptance to his auspices of the celebration of the 50th anniversary of the Supreme Constitutional Court Golden Jubilee, in the occasion of the 50th anniversary of establishing the Constitutional Court and his support and auspices of such a celebration. It's a day in the history of the Egyptian constitutional jurisdiction that the whole history would be proud of. 50 years have passed from the establishment of the constitutional jurisdiction and the Supreme Constitutional Court given its rule at the highest level, supported by the help of the Almighty God on the complexities of the issues that review. Such complexities reflected by litigations, people would say sometimes it's null for the infringement of the Constitution. Hence, the court was committed to its methodology in response to what is being divided of its branches for the origins that gather them, and to explain or to review the hopes of the societies as considered to the framework of the values embraced by the Constitution. Its implication shouldn't be solid, difficult to be innovated or isolated of its environment or to precipice the facts of the our living era, strained by situations that the history have already have forgotten. The good esteemed people, the role of the Supreme Constitutional Court is passing its role solid without any hesitation to embrace by the message of the Constitution, or rather its mission, inspiring the hopes of a successive generations that forsake the right as a result and the liberty as a flag, and the justice is the hope, determined to be the constitutional legitimacy, to be as the shining light on top of each forehead, by purifying the legislation from its faults. To avoid defending a very tight and closed interest, by affirming as always that the liberty is the hope and innovation, and the launching for a vast horizon that is limitless despite its differences, and it is the main soil and seed of the life, and enhancing the rights laid out by the Constitution, so by its implementation and imposed of its beneficiaries. Since then, that is working such a court, working as opening by its realizations of the hopes of the nations to perform its mission and message, not to be avoided of its direction, of such a direction, not to interfere by speed or objecting it by releasing him from its struggling strains, provided to be provocative and as described the final result, and not to be considered as a substitutional measurement. It was the fact that the public freedoms and liberty to be its in top priorities, and its sides of success is the goal, achieving its demand. The Supreme Constitutional Court has faced very important constitutional issues, and very accurate, as serious as such, in different of jurisdiction branches. It had doing its message, laid out by the Constitution to respond or such issues to their originals, and extracting its branches, voiding or putting aside what claimed by some people of the oriental, the oriented or directed nature of some of such of some constitutional texts, exposing that the constitutions cannot just apply in a very absolute right to be or to make the lawmakers equal with the citizens, united, showing the logic bond of the Constitution's text that are divided at large
وليس ذلك إلا اعترافا منها بوحدة هذه النصوص وتوافقها.
Acknowledging of the unity of the and the the sound texts that they are
وأنها متآلفة فيما بينها
paired among each of them
ولا يقصد بها
not to be intended to be away and lost in the space or its generated interpretation to be isolated of the collective view that they are based on. Ladies and gentlemen,
لقد أقامت المحكمة الدستورية
the Supreme Constitutional Court
قضاءها على
محاور established its jurisdictions on very connected pivots
في مجموعها
to establish in its collective
متكاملا
a complete building for its creed preserving the very vital principles that the community cannot be raised without or away of it representing the hopes and great aspiration that that it seeks to reach its core is the guarantee of the personal liberty and the purification of the forms of development of the life, releasing its tools of strains imposed on it, that they are imposed. This is not just the overcome the executive and legislative powers, but to be based on that no one cannot be a hinder of on the Constitution. Those are required to abide with.
من خلال ولوج طرائق
Abiding
الرقابة
imposed
على دستورية النصوص
would be
القانونية
otherwise,
التي عينها قانون المحكمة الدستورية العليا
such text assigned by the Supreme Constitutional Court to decide the annulment of such text or its sound
وهو ما يعني
which means
أن بقاءها أو زوالها
that
عائد في منتهاه
the annulment or its sound it is returned in its goal of it by affirming the highest status by the revision of the legislative authorities. The role of the Supreme Constitutional Court's role
من كفالة سيادة القواعد الدستورية على كل أنواع القواعد القانونية
affirmative of the constitutional rules throughout all the authorities and communities whether they are issued by the executive nor the legislative authorities by respecting of the highest status of the Constitution considered the highest principles through the escalations of the legal ranks. The Supreme Court as such is an establishment issued by the Constitution to abind all those authorized to issue rules to be abided by the rules and values of the Constitutions. And the state to be abiding by its forms of such constitutional rules that cannot be overcome. Therefore, to be the control of its behaviors to achieve the subordinations of the state of all such texts in order to reach the judicial state or the state of law that is subject of all such principles and
preserve and the rights of the citizens and their liberties, nation to would have been established but to maintain, to preserve of such any aggressions and achieve such flourishment. Such rules made by a relentless will and determination to have its only path, not to hesitate of establishing its content. Its well was solid and deep, not to be hindered or obstacles to continue its path, yet it was vested by determination to take into the force of the right and its deeps. It cannot be imagined that the Supreme Constitutional Court overcome the constitutional clauses or texts, but interpreted and implemented to be in parallel with or to be in particularly inconcised with the changed environments of the era that they are living in.
ولا فهمها على ضوء فلسفة بعينها.
Not to be comprehended by a specific philosophy. It was just orientation towards a new tomorrow.
أو القبول بها.
To be accepted cannot be, or rather implemented, implying to be just in just a syllable in the sea.
غدا مصير الوطن
مرتبطاً in their eyes the fate of the nation
التي يتطلبها تحرير
as well as the higher values required in the level of the economics and politics. In its sphere is just to be in a very very innovative system. Its core pulse of life and maintained by its core as an explanation to be an accompaniment and a very decided competence established by the Constitution. Hence to be strained by the border it's laid out and cannot be comprehended that the supervision of the Supreme Constitutional Court of the constitutional legislation would hinder the work of the executive and legislative powers. Correctly, they or its releases from its strains, and it's not logically that its release threaten the would breach the stability of the state or the nation. The court was abiding to review the original clauses and texts that were in depth of the old histories and historical nations. Of such restraints, the constitutional rule for the interest of the laws, which means that the origin of what being issued by the legislative authority, that they are issued within the limits of the Constitution. Therefore, a judge, upon reviewing the constitutional form of such legislation, to take this into consideration. They cannot be avoided or deprived from such a rule. The contradiction to
was between the law and the constitution, so would be very clear and crystal otherwise. I.e., the court cannot issue the unconstitutional laws unless its breach would the constitution reasonably, in reasonable form. There is also another restraint that the role of the Supreme Constitutional Court cannot be limited to the review of the legislative text only, but to be extended to contain the factor of consistency. The court relies on the impact of its role, its impact on the economic, social, and political arenas. Not to exacerbate the revision or to be deprived from.
وإذا أمكن تفسير
if possible,
القانون على أكثر من وجه
interpret the law in more than one
يجعله متفقا مع
way
الدستور
that is
comparable
with the constitution
هذا الوجه في
the
تفسير القانون
court is shall abide on implementation such a law
دون تكليف نفسها عناء البحث عن نية
without exerting the effort of the comprehension of the legislator or its goal.
الإخوة الحضور.
Ladies and gentlemen, the God-esteemed public.
الإخوة الحضور. إذا كان الدستور
If the Constitution stipulated the rights, liberties of the citizens, the Supreme Constitutional Court is the sole determiner by its rules, its frames, and its context. Whereas the Supreme Constitutional Court affirmed the values and principles of the constitutional values and principles, mentioning some of it, firstly, that the all human were born freed and equal of their duties and rights, therefore cannot be discriminated in their treatment of any form. Objective reasons by showing that otherwise. Secondly, the liberty of beliefs is absolute. The practices of religious rituals is the right of the divine legislation. Thirdly, the maintenance of the constitution as a private priority would abide the legislator to execute
him
or her, not allowed to distract him or shorten its branches without any social necessities. Fourthly,
sign
or given the punishment cannot punishment cannot be paid without any wrong.
Fifth,
the human has a creed and natural rights, its humanity cannot be maintained without.
And
on top of which,
the
right of providing the kind and life
a group of laws cannot be deprived from.
Sixth,
the right of life in a specific community cannot be integrated by erasing its identities and breaching the rights of the others. By its behavior, such should be based on principles that aim the most participation of the public life.
Seventh,
just an equality between the people of the states are right regardless of their belongings, politicals or religious.
States
protections decided by the Supreme Court extended through the citizens for those who are residents, given the minimum of rights that cannot be avoided. Ninth, protections stipulated such maintenance of duties and liberty cannot be limited of the political rights, but contain personal and other rights. Tenth, maintenance of litigation right is a principal guarantee for the citizens.
Eleventh,
the jurisdiction independence is a primal principle that the justice are based upon, and they are in parallel and part and parcel. The God esteemed gathering is just a few of many of principles issued or established by the Egyptian constitution through the past 50 years of its establishment, laid out by very informative men and their comprehension and their eagerness of establishing the rules of the Egyptian constitution that follow. As a contribution from them to strengthen the pillars of our dear Egyptian state. Their call were just based on the right. Their seek and eagerness were based on the belief of such a mission or their mission. It is the Supreme Constitutional Court. Its judges have taken the right as the only and sole path, that their tongue were articulated, their path were just straight, and it became right that the Constitutional Court to live up with its highest. Its determination is only based on its message, its righteous path, its call was only the right. We pray to the Almighty God to give us the sound pass and peace be upon you all. We'll play now a very documentary film on the Supreme Constitutional
Court of Egypt in 50 years.
Amen. حصنا منيعا للدفاع عن حقوق وحريات المواطنين منذ 50 عام.
المحكمة الدستورية العليا المصرية من أقدم المحاكم على مستوى العالم، ولها إسهامات متميزة في مجال القضاء الدستوري العالمي بما أرسته من مبادئ وأحكام وقيم دستورية وحددت به الحقوق والحريات.
عام 1969 أنشئت أول محكمة تتولى الرقابة القضائية على دستورية القوانين في مصر، وهي المحكمة العليا. سنة 1971 صدر الدستور المصري، ولأول مرة نص على إنشاء محكمة الدستورية العليا التي بدأ العمل بها عام 1979، وبذلك تركزت الرقابة القضائية على دستورية التشريعات في محكمة واحدة دون غيرها.
الدور الفاعل للقضاء الدستوري في المجتمع لا يقف عند حد تحقيق الرقابة القضائية على دستورية القوانين واللوائح، بل يمتد ليشمل تحديد مضامين وأطر حقوق وحريات المواطنين، والتي يعد الخروج عليها مخالفة لأحكام الدستور.
رحلة المحكمة الدستورية العليا على مدار الخمسة عقود الماضية من 1969 إلى 2019 هي محل افتخار وتقدير، مش مننا احنا بس قضاة المحكمة الدستورية العليا، وإنما هي فخر لكل المصريين. الدور الكبير اللي قامت به المحكمة بقيادة رجال عظام أمثال الدكتور عوض المر، اللي بعبقريته ارتقى بالقضاء الدستوري المصري إلى العالمي.
على مدار 50 عاما لعبت المحكمة دورا رئيسيا في حماية حقوق المواطنين السياسية، وأصدرت أحكاما هامة بشأن حق الترشح والانتخاب، وكانت بحق القلعة التي منعت التمييز بين المواطنين على أسس سياسية.
احنا شفنا تطورات كبيرة جدا فيما يتعلق بدور الإنسان المصري وضعه بالنسبة للمنظومة السياسية. شفنا أحكام صدرت عن المحكمة في مجال الحقوق السياسية، لعل من أهمها الإشراف القضائي على الانتخابات. شفنا أحكام مهمة جدا في مجال وضع البرلمان المصري، أدى الأمر بالمحكمة في بعض الحالات إلى الحق لحل البرلمانات في ذلك الوقت، وده شفناه في مناسبات عديدة. كل دي خطوات من نور خطها قضاة المحكمة الدستورية منذ نشأتها.
وفي الأوقات العصيبة ظلت المحكمة الدستورية العليا صامدة في وجه الحصار، وعندما حانت اللحظة كانت حائط الصد الذي استند عليه المواطنون في الفترة الانتقالية.
يؤدي رئيس المحكمة الدستورية العليا اليمين أمام الجمعية العامة للمحكمة.
أحسن بالله العظيم أن أحافظ مخلصا على النظام الجمهوري، وأن أحترم الدستور والقانون، وأن أرعى مصالح الشعب رعاية كاملة، وأن أحافظ على استقلال الوطن وسلامة أراضي.
شهدت المحكمة لحظة تاريخية فاصلة في مسيرتها. أدى خلالها الرئيس السيسي اليمين الدستورية أمام الجمعية العامة للمحكمة الدستورية العليا.
العظيم أن أحافظ مخلصا على النظام الجمهوري، وأن أحترم الدستور والقانون، وأن أرعى مصالح الشعب رعاية كاملة، وأن أحافظ على استقلال الوطن ووحدة وسلامة أرضي.
على قدر ما تتمتع به مصر من أدوار إقليمية ودولية البارزة كان للمحكمة الدستورية العليا المصرية أدوارها البارزة إقليميا ودوليا.
في يونيو سنة 1997 أنشئ اتحاد المحاكم والمجالس الدستورية العربية كمنظمة دولية تعمل على توطيد وترسيخ المبادئ والقيم الدستورية في الدول العربية.
واليوم تحتفل المحكمة الدستورية العليا بمرور نصف قرن على إنشائها، وتؤكد أنها ستظل دوما قلعة لحماية حقوق المصريين.
السادة الحضور، ضيوف مصر الكرام، سعدنا بتشريفكم اليوم في هذه الاحتفالية بمرور 50 عاما على إنشاء المحكمة الدستورية العليا، ونترك حضراتكم لاستكمال باقي الفعاليات.
Excellencies, the Supreme Constitutional Court of Egypt remains always a source of pride throughout history. Thank you so much for sharing the quote today, this wonderful opportunity to celebrate remarkable achievements in half a century. And we're definitely looking forward to its next thriving 50 years to come. Thank you so much for coming and sharing.
شكرا لحضرتك.